everybody, my name is Ana Padilla. I'm the program coordinator for the Yuma Art Center, and today I have a little tutorial for all of you that are at home and don't know what to do with so much time, or you have little kids. So this is one of the projects that we have done possibly in the past with some of our ArtSmart camp classes. And so what I have today is we're gonna make a sculpture out of like cardboard. And so what I'm using, I had to put together some furniture from IKEA, so I had a lot of leftover pieces of cardboard, so I thought this would be good for the kids. So you can use any cardboard that you may have at home. So this is like one piece right here, so it's a little chunkier, but then I have ones that are a little bit thinner, and then some other ones that are just like regular cardboard right here. So any kind of like type of assortment, TP rolls, any kind of like cardboard that you can come in, that you have, you can put together. You'll need glue for sure, and probably a pair of scissors, X-Acto knife. This is for the parents if you need to cut something that is a little bit thicker, and also a ruler may come in handy. Now let your imagination flow. Anything can work, and we're gonna leave it as just the craft color, but you can also spray paint it, you can make it gold, you can make it silver, you can make it according to the colors that you might need. So it will be an abstract sculpture, but hopefully you will enjoy it. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use this as my base right here. So I'm just gonna leave it right here, but then I'm gonna start adding pieces of the cardboard so that way we can build it and hopefully make it somehow interesting. So what I'm gonna do next, I'm gonna grab this longer piece. I just don't want it to be like a tear cake. So I'm gonna cut it a little bit. So I'm gonna try to stay within the camera so that way you can actually see. So being really careful, cutting this with the X-Acto knife. These things are very sharp, so you may wanna be very, very careful when you're cutting. So here we go. And then they break kind of like fairly easy once you have it all done. So I'm gonna use the bigger piece. I'm not gonna leave it like straight, I'm just gonna leave it a little bit slanted so way I'll build up the different. I'm gonna put some glue over here. I know some parents may think that hot glue will work faster, and you can also use that as well. I'm just using this for the safety of the kiddos. I'm gonna add this piece right here, then I have a little leftover, so I'll wait on that one. I'm going to use some of my thicker one right here, so I'm cutting another extra piece. I'm thinking about this right here, and right here I don't really have a plan. I'm just letting my imagination go, and usually those are like the coolest pieces that you can have. And you know how they have all these like different and abstract pieces at the stores that they look super cool, so this is something to get a little on the creative side of it. So I use the flat side. So I'm gonna put some glue on the bottom right here. Don't overdo it because I'm using like just some Elmer's glue, and so we're gonna have to let it dry. So I'm probably gonna have to do this in two steps or something. So I'm just gonna add this right here, let it sit right there. Okay, so you can see we're like building it around these things. So there you go. And then I'll use another piece of this. I'm gonna try to make it grow up. So and sometimes when you are starting to build stuff like this, you have to find like, where is the support? How is this going to stay? Is this going to work? Do I have to do like a support on the middle or something? Sometimes you can just use like a little tiny piece just to hold on to it, just to stay in place, but I think this will work fine. So I'm just gonna add some glue right here, and then some on this bottom part. And then sometimes you may want to add extra glue on the top just to make sure that it won't sit on the right spot. Okay, so I'm just gonna add a little dip on this on the back part. I'll show you in a little bit. So this like this right here, so that way it will like glue together. And remember, some of these projects will need patience, so that way you are able to wait on it. And so I think I'm going to add one more piece to this, just to let's see. And this is where creativity starts like kicking in, and seeing what will look better, if it's going to work. Sometimes you just gotta wait, because as you can see, this is like not staying on the right spot. So I'm gonna have to wait for it to add the next piece. Let me see one more time. We might be able to try this. Yeah, I think it's going to work. I like it. So let me just put some glue inside. Make sure that whenever it's a piece like this that seems to be floating on the top, you want to make sure that you have plenty of glue inside, so that way it will stay better. So then holding them together and then just adding the little piece in here. Let's see. I think that's going to work. Okay. So we have a little sculpture right here. Always make sure to cover this back up or put it in a safe place, so that way you will not cut yourself. So here you go. So I'm gonna let this dry. Probably it's gonna be a couple hours, so it might take me a little longer to keep going. And I know that probably I did it like super fast, because I already had all of the materials, and so I kind of like had an idea in my head about how I wanted to look like. So just gotta make sure that, whoops. And that's what happened when you start moving things around, but nothing that cannot be put back together. So let's put more glue over here, just to make sure. Maybe I should add glue over here as well, just to for this thing to stay together. So let's put this back on. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna let it dry for a couple of hours, and then we'll come back over, and then we'll probably, I'll see what kind of paint I have at home, and we'll continue to finish this project. Okie dokie, so we're back. I'm back with the sculpture. So it had passed, I will say about an hour and a half. And so it's still, as you can see, some of the glue is still kind of white right there. Also on this other side, so I'm gonna be very careful when I start painting this. Everything else seems like it's kind of like secure. So I also wanted to show you what you can use for it. You can use some markers to color on it, so kids can just use what you have around, so that way you don't have to get out of your house and have to go get supplies. I also have found some acrylic paint that I used before, and so I'll show you how you can do one way or the other, so that way you can finish up the project. Also, if you have some spray paint, that will work as well, because that way you just like take it outside, spray really quick, do like an even coat on each side and let it air dry for maybe an hour or so, and then you can have a really nice piece that you can bring back home. Don't have any spray paint, but I do have the markers, I do have the acrylic paint. So on one side I will do like the markers, so that way that's something that the kids can do. If you don't have markers, you don't have paint, but you have crayons, you can also use the crayons, so that way you use what you have available around as well. I have a couple other ideas that I'll be sharing with you as well for the next couple of days or so, of the different things that kids can do as well with things that you already have home. As you can see, this one has like a really cool texture. I'm just gonna pull it down a little bit so you can, that way it will be faster. So I'm not trying to color every single spot in here. I wanna keep some of that texture right there as well. And then you can see, that right there too. So as you can see, there's some texture right there, so it doesn't have to be completely done and covered. So that can be one color, then we can use some other colors as well. Let's pink one here that I'm planning on using. So I can use that right here. Oops, I think this one's dried out, so we might use that one. Let's see, here's another one. Yeah, that one has some color. So as you can see, that gives you some texture. And it should add some different colors. So this is some good ideas to have your kids entertained and such, so that way they stay busy. And as I said, if you receive packages, and sometimes there's a bubble wrap in there, so there's some other ideas you can use with that. But at least you have this right here. Now, if you want yours to be a little bit more formal, more something that may go into like a living room space or something like that, then I'm gonna try this other side. So mine is gonna be a double-sided for right now, but let's see if I can open this. I hope this is hasn't dried up on me. It's been quite a bit since I used it open up. So I'm gonna use some white paint, since most of my stuff around my house is like very basic colors. So grayish and whites and such. So, oh, this is like nice and super cool. This is more of a high-end paint, but this is what I have available today. So this is what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna start right here, just giving a nice even coat onto it. And then once again, if you you wanted more cover or something like that, I'm trying to do one brush stroke up, so that way my brush strokes are even, and that way you don't see. Now, you don't have to do it like that. You can also have like the you can just see like all the texture there as well. So there we have white. Let me just grab a little bit more paint, and then and I'm gonna move on onto this piece right here. I like when things are very minimalist, so that they don't require a lot. And then, you know, you can have like really cool staples added onto the house. Sometimes you're looking for that little detail to put in one spot or something, and this can be pretty cool. And sometimes they look like they're super heavy, but in reality they're not that heavy, because they're just cardboard, so it also helps for them to be easy to put like on little shelves on the wall, or just on a table, or like a different spot. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this side on the top right here. As you notice, I'm not doing the ends. I'm gonna try to keep the ends the color of the craft paper. Just think that the texture on them is pretty cool. So I might add something to them in a little bit. So here you go. Also, you can change the colors. You can add different colors in here, depending on the colors of your home. You can change them up as well. I'm just using plain white because I just feel like this is gonna go well around my house. Also, if you would like to see some other kind of tutorials or like something else that you would like to learn, let us know, so that way we'll can get ready and show you as well some other things that you can do as well. So if you do wanna add some color to this, I'm just gonna go like this. Just adding a little bit of color right there. Now if you do wanna go all white, well, you just go ahead and grab more paint and then just add it in there. And so that way it will be all one solid white color, or depending on the color that you choose. Let me just add a little bit more on the front, and then I'll let these dry. Also, cardboard absorbs quite a bit of paint, so you may use more than what you were expecting. So as you can see, right now you're looking at my colorful side, And so, here we go. I'm just gonna add some white on the color side of it as well. Since I'm already over here, so I may as well just add it on. Just to finish. So there you go. So if you do want to add more onto these right here, this is just going over with the brush with the paint that is left over on here. Just get that a little more. Now if you don't like to show these edges right here, you can also, if you have ribbon or just another solid piece of paper that you want to put around it, you can also do so. Okay. Let's see. Here we go. Over here. A little bit more. Going on the top over here. And right now I'm just using the leftover paint from my brush. And then just like adding some of these colors around here. Now the paint that I'm using is acrylic, so you may want to be careful. I got some on my hands, but this will come off. But if you are, make sure you don't get it on your clothes. Sometimes it will not come off from your clothes. So just be aware of that. So be really a little mindful and careful with that. Or just wear clothes that you don't mind getting paint on them. That's what I normally do. Okay, so here we go. Here's a little quick sculpture. And as I said, on the other side, I had like the colorful side of it. Now, if you do have more paint or you have spray paint, as I said, you can just spray paint it gold. I'm gonna try to see if I can find some gold paint. I know I don't have any in the house, but maybe next time I go and do a pickup or something at the store, I might be able to get some of that. So once again, leave us a comment or let us know what you think and what you would like to do. So thank you. Have a good one. It's good to see you. Stay safe and healthy. Have a great day.